Welcome back, my beautiful viewers. And it's been a minute since we did a haul. I went shopping. Oh my god. So we'll get straight into it. Everything you see here is about $56. I don't know how much it was individually. I know it's a tiny package. I know it looks like a tiny package. But there's some really good stuff in here. Okay. Alright. So we're just gonna get right into it. Alright. Ooh, okay. First that's some signs. Alrighty. Oh, this is gonna be funny. Now I'm trying to think. Can we just rip the tape off the front? We're just gonna open it up. Okay. Come on. And yes, they are metal, so it's gonna be indoors, outdoors. I'm looking at a fun place to put this. Alrighty. I don't know where I'm gonna put this, but this is so nice. Actually, this is my circus. These are my monkeys. Enjoy the show. Oh my god. That is like, you know, not my fleas, not my circus. You know, the mind. Okay. And oh, I don't want to say this one too. You know that that old saying, seize the day. No. Come on. Here we go. Actually, pretty sure I seized the wrong day. Love these. Okay, so those are there. Oh, and this last. Oh, that's small. That's small, but I love this. I don't know where I'm going to put these. I have no idea where I'm going to put these signs. I know that back there, back there it's going to be all my Pride Come June. And I don't know where I'm going to put none of these. But relax. We're all crazy. It's not a competition. Okay, we're all nuts. It's different level of nuts, but we're all nuts. Wait. Alrighty. It's a good thing I have a desk, because I can always pull this out, sit this there. What the heck? What is that? I feel... Okay, you could tell. Okay, I need this there. I thought I was done. Lo and behold, I'm not. Okay, so this is deep. Oh my god. Okay. I thought this was gonna be. Okay, so this is a shark. I thought it was gonna be the dolphin. Dang it, I bought the wrong one. When buying molds, make sure you're mindful. Because this is that way. If it was when it's up and down like that, when the tail is up and down like that, in line with the fin on the top, it's a fish. If it goes sideways, that's in line with the pectoral fins, it's a mammal. Long story. Okay. Fish have gills, mammals have lungs. Again, long story. Oh no, that's wrong. Anyway, this is a shark. You could tell it's a shark because of, well, I don't even think you could see that. But yeah. Damn it, I bought the wrong one. But look how much this is gonna take, at least. Wow. A kilo of resin. That's going to take $30, $40 worth of resin just to make. Then you wonder why they're so expensive. Oh. So that's that would be a good example, like to put marbles in there, or to put some kind of beading in there, because then it takes up space, and I won't have to use up so much resin, and then I don't have to charge people 300 grams of resin. Anyway, so as you could tell, this is a pumpkin, so that's gonna go up like that. You always want to fill these from the bottom. You really do. If you're wondering how that trick is done, always fill it from the bottom. Alright, what the heck did I buy? Oh, okay. This is what they call a teardrop. This is what they call a teardrop trinket box. Because you can see, you see that? Yeah, that little teardrop. I love that little design. So it looks like one of those Moroccan cooking bowls. Yeah, that's a teardrop. That's some way bigger than I thought. That's one thing. These silicone molds like that, they're expensive. They are very expensive. So if you want a hobby, if you want to get into a hobby, Temu is a great place for hobbyists because they get some really good stuff for hardly any money. And there's nothing wrong with it. Basically, when stuff is being sold like that, you know, and, ooh, this is a big old strawberry. Look at that. And then you can put like that, you know, again, you fill them from the bottom. But when they're on sale, that you're getting a huge piece for hardly any money, it's not necessarily that the product is defective. It's that either changing companies, changing packaging, changing design, something's changing and they need to get rid of the old stock. And they don't have time to wait, basically. So I'm like, okay. Oh, that's quite big. Ooh. Okay. So here's a little crab. A resin crab. So I can make like a real thin. That's a lot thinner than I thought. That's fine. We could go ahead and make a crab and put a pin on that. And here's some dragons. That's supposed to be a lot, let's see, how does that feel weird? One feels a lot thicker than the other, but it's a progressive pride, so everyone's shown. And what else do we need? Oh, crapola, that's huge. Peep bunnies, a set of three. Those are a lot bigger than I thought they would be. A lot of these will surprise you of how big they are. So let me go ahead and move these down here. Okay. Move that there. This. I'm trying to make it so that you can actually see these color resins. So we got that there. And what I did is that the wife bought me some samples. So I got to try all the colors before you make up your mind. And then that was the jewel collection. This is the standard color collection or primary color collection. That's why. So from there, I'll choose the ones that I like. But yeah, that's a full-size bottle. And depending on how you use these. Okay, that's the outline color. So I'm not worried about that one that just fell on the floor. But what these colors do, what you do is that you make something like this with it. see. Oh no, it's upside down. There you go. Oh, you can see that it's a betta fish, so you get these little fluorescent or these little glow sticks. Not glow sticks, but the little coloring. Yeah. So I could, if I want to use a blue background to this, I shouldn't use the purple or the blue. I could think of this better next time I pour one of these, but this is like my second pour. I've done it way better. My first pour was a disaster. So that's what you would do with these. These were to fill in the fine lines and then you pour in. Let's see, could I do it with this? Probably not, because I can't get in there. Now, I could use this with the crab. I could use this with the crab to fill in a little, the fine lines, and then pour the resin and set it. So, yes, this is going to be very useful, very much fun. A great place for a hobbyist. If you want to get some really good supplies for your hobby, I would definitely go to Temu. There's nothing wrong with their products. You know, because it's there. Stuff is collecting. It's collecting dust. It's overstock. And if you don't get the decent price, I guarantee you, someone else is going to take it from you. So you might as well get in there and get yourself a good bargain. And whether it's clothes, kitchenware, garden stuff, hobbyist toys for the kids, whatever, they have everything. So until next time, guys, we're going to hope for the best. We're going to prepare for the worst. But I guarantee you kids will all end up somewhere in the middle. Till next time. Bye.